Hello friends, today we are going to see non-traditional process, that is a electrical discharge machining, which is also called as a EDM. It is a basically a thermal process. In this, we'll cover the principle of EDM, setup of EDM, process or a controlling parameter of EDM, and its application. Now, as per the introductory part is concerned, whenever the sparking takes place between the two electrical contact, a small amount of material is removed from each of the contact. This fact is used to produce the spark between tool and the workpiece in the EDM. So here, when you are taking the two electrical contact, the spark will get generated, and this spark is used to remove the material from the workpiece. It is also called as a spark erosion machine. So this is the actual setup of the EDM. Principle of working of EDM machine. The EDM works on the principle that heat generated by the spark is used to remove the material from the workpiece. So here the spark which has been generated is utilized to remove the material. The tool and the workpiece here, tool will act as a cathode and workpiece will act as a anode. And the gap between these two is maintained from 0.01 mm to 0.5 mm. And the tool and the workpiece, they both are immersed in the dielectric fluid. The spark produces, when the supply is made on, the thousands of sparks can be generated. And due to that, the duration of the each spark is very short. When the spark comes in contact with the dielectric fluid, so here the dielectric fluid we are using as a kerosene or a lubricating oil or a distilled water there, and then what this allows the current to flow between the tool and the workpiece here, and the temperatures which has been generated, which is a very high temperature, that is a 10,000 degree centigrade, and which is produced between this spark region, I can say. Okay, and due to this reason, the naturally the material will get removed from the workpiece. Setup of EDM. So here in the, as per the setup is concerned, will the four major components are there. So first we'll see the tool and the workpiece. Here the tool and the workpiece, this is a tool and this is a workpiece, which is kept in this reservoir. Reservoir means in the one tank, and it is connected to the DC supply. The tool is always connected to the negative terminal here. And as per the workpiece is concerned, it is connected to the positive terminal. This is the workpiece, okay, and it is connected to the positive terminal of the DC supply. Second is the dielectric fluid system. Here in the dielectric fluid system, which is stored inside this tank, and this has been pumped with the help of this pump, and then it is just to inject by using the nozzle between the tool and the workpiece. So dielectric fluid, again we are using the, here the lubricating oil, kerosene or a distilled water there. The third is a tool feed mechanism. Yeah, so here in the tool feed mechanism, during the operation, both this tool and the workpiece get eroded, and so due to that reason, it is necessary to feed the tool continuously, because you have to maintain the gap between this tool and the workpiece, and it is only possible through this servo system. So due to that reason, we can maintain the gap. RC circuit and the power supply unit. Here you can see in the diagram here. So resistance and capacitance we are using, the same circuit we are shown here. In this case, the resistance is connected in the series and the capacitor is connected in parallel. And when the supply, when we supply, the supply is made on, the capacitor voltage will start rising here now. And when the capacitor voltage is equal to breakdown voltage, a spark discharge will occur. Here the discharge will take place. And the capacitor is then discharged, and again we are, as it gets discharged, again you have to recharge it, and the cycle will repeat it number of times. Resistance are in the circuit prevent the charging of capacitor before the spark gap get ionized. So that is a basic function of the resistance why we are using here. Process parameter. In the process parameters, we can see the six basic parameters here. First is the supply voltage, as we are using the DC power supply, and the voltage we can use between the range of 50 volt to 400 volt, which depends upon the material to be removed. Second parameter is the breakdown voltage. So it is the voltage at which dielectric breakdown. So it means what happened in this case, as the breakdown voltage increases, the naturally the spark energy will also goes on increasing. And consequently, the naturally what happens in this case, the when the material removed, in this case, in the material removal rate will MMRV, material removal rate goes on increasing. But as per the surface finish is concerned, it is little bit poor there. Resistance and capacitance. As we increase the capacitance, naturally the what happens, that material removed will also goes on increasing. Now as the resistance decreases, will result in increasing the, naturally the material removal rate will also increases. Spark gap setting, as we see that the gap between the tool and the workpiece has to be maintained. So here what happens there, as the spark gap decreases, so material removal rate will also decreases. And in this case, the whatever the components we are producing will get a very high accuracy and high surface finish in this case. Pulse duration, it is the duration between the successive pulses for producing. As the pulse duration decreases, the tool wear will increases. Again, if the pulse duration, if you are increasing now the pulse duration, so naturally the tool wear will occur. Then spark frequency, in the thousands of spark can be produced per second. So in this case, what happened, as the spark frequency increases, the quality which produced or the product which has been produced is also get a high finish there. So because of the spark energy is shared by more number of spark. As per the application is concerned, it is used in making the stamping, die drawing and extrusion dies, header dies, forging dies. See here I have shown some applications. Practically, this is the stamp tools, right? And in this case, I shown some dies there. This is especially the forging dies. So this is a basic applications of the EDM. Internal threads can be produced in a hardened material by using a rotatory spindle. So if you want to produce the internal thread, okay, so it is possible in the EDM. So this is how I shown the example. Then in machining, delicate workpiece like copper parts are used for fitting in the vacuum. So this is the part which I shown, which is a copper. which is made up of copper, and as per the application is concerned, so in the vacuum tubes mostly we are using this. Then for machining exotic material using the aerospace industry, especially here, this is what we have shown the example there or applications there. In the resharpening of cutting tools and broaches, here if you want to go for the resharpening of the tools, right? So different type of tools can be resharpening by using the applications of the EDA by this process. This is again, if you want to produce the micro holes there, then again it is possible in this case. And these are the very different parts I have shown in which is possible to produce in the EDM. So thank you, my friend.